Inside of Unreal Engine 5, self-illuminated materials are known as emissive materials. In the following video, we will be covering how you set up your materials to use the emissive input as well as how you can use the emissive input to actually light the world that you are creating. The emissive color input controls which parts of your material will glow or emit light, and the brightness of the emission. Ideally, this input will receive a masked texture, mostly black except the areas that need to glow. Emissive lighting, or in UE5, emissive materials, give artists a very cheap and effective way to give the illusion that a material is casting light when it really is not. Emissive materials do this by allowing artists to push the values of the emissive input higher than 1.0, which will push the material into the HDR range, giving off a bloom effect that you might see when looking at a very bright light source. Here we have created two cubes for showing the comparison of a normal material and emissive material. And of course three walls, so as to create a darker environment. You can create new materials from the content browser. Creating emissive materials is no different than creating any other material inside of UE4. So we already have material in the name of new mat. We will make a duplicate of it and name it as emissive. Now we will apply both the material on each cubes. Let's see what is normal material. On opening the new mat, it's a 3-vector attached to the base color which gives the basic color. And some 2 vectors attached to roughness and metallic. So apply the emissive also. Both the material are the same as there is no change in the emissive material. Now go to the emissive material editor. Disconnect the base color from base color. This can be done by pressing Alt and left mouse button. And then connect the same with emissive color input. So the graph looks like this. Then save and go back and check the change in cube. Now it's glowing compared to the left one, which is basically normal color mapping. And the right one has an emissive color. Emissive materials are self-illuminating, which means that they can be used with both lit and unlit shading models. However, whenever possible, emissive materials should use the unlit shading model as it will result in a shader that is cheaper to render. There is also no visual difference between the two different shading models in terms of how the emissive is rendered. When using the emissive input to light the world, you might find that the effect is either too subtle or too powerful. To fix this, any materials that are created should have a way to adjust the influence of the emissive light being cast into the world. Here in this case, we can't change the intensity of the glow, so we have to add 1 scalar parameter. So press 1 and left mouse button. And convert the same into parameters. Name it emissive strength. Now on the left hand side, you will see default values for emissive strength. Set the default value as 0, and max value as 200. With the material expression nodes now labeled and filled in, it is now time to start to wire everything together. The most important part to make sure to wire up correctly is the emissive input, as without that, no emissive will work. Now add 1 multiply node onto the graph. Connect 1 node to emissive strength and other to the base color. And the connect the out execution pin to the emissive color. When completed, your material graph should look like the following. Now that the material is wired up, make sure to compile and save the material by pressing both the apply and save buttons at the top of the material editor. Now that the material has been compiled and closed, find the material in the content browser and then right-click on the material and choose the Create Material Instance option to make a material instance from the emissive material. To change a parameter, you must first enable the parameter by using the left mouse button to click on the checkmark box that is next to the name of the parameter you want to enable. After clicking, a checkmark should be added to the box and both the name and the input area will no longer be grayed out. Now it is just a matter of inputting the values that you want to use and saving the material instance. In the shader that we created above, this parameter was called emissive strength. By increasing the emissive strength, you will increase the amount of light that is cast into the world when building light. Decreasing the emissive strength, you will lessen the amount of light that is cast into the world. In the images, you can see how increasing the emissive strength increases the emissive effect on the world. Here in this examples of what happens when we set the emissive strength to a value of 0 on the left, 1 in the middle, and 25 on the right. You can input textures, numbers, or a combination of both into the emissive input. What you input really depends on the needs of the material. If the emissive material is just to simulate light, then using a numeric value instead of a texture is the way to go. However, if you want to simulate lights on an object, using a texture as a emissive mask is the way to go, as you can define in the mask texture exactly which parts should be illuminated. In the example above, we used emissive masking as we used a texture to define where the emissive parts of the material should be. In the texture parameter, choose any texture of your choice. We have taken Alisplay logo on it. You can add various input node and connect the same, so the final graph would look like this. Connect the wires and your final graph should look like this. Now save. And go back to the material instance. Here change the value of emissive strength and observe the lightness. Here the whole thing is glowing. We can make the body dim and have only logo glowing by change the base color. In order to see the effects the emissive will have on the world, you need to build your level lighting. If you do not do this, your changes will not be seen. This also means that whenever you make a change to the emissive material, you will also need to rebuild lighting to see the changes. You can also change the color of the emissive by changing the emissive color vector parameter. Here are some examples of what changing the color of the emissive looks like. Hope from this video, you will start to move into building in more advanced mechanics, in an easy to follow step-by-step approach, which will allow you to play around and build your own content, to eventually build your own game. Thanks a lot, see you in the next video.